We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Batman Superman issue 10. This issue was written by Joshua Williams with art by Clayton Henry. Alejandro Sanchez was the colorist, John J. Hill letterer. Clayton Henry and Alejandro Sanchez did the cover. Ben Mears was the assistant editor, Paul Kaminsky editor, Ben Abernathy group editor. Batman is looking at the remains of the atomic skull and trying to get a clue as to what is happening. And he does get a little bit of a lead, and it leads him to a facility that disposes of technology, dangerous technologies, experimental, outdated stuff, and he learns that something was stolen. And that's when the heroes figure out that behind it is the Ultrahumanite. Not ruining anything because it's on the cover. We do get a recap of the origin of the Ultrahumanite in here, as well as a flashback of the last time he encountered Superman, which was kind of cool. And then the two heroes are beset by some drones, mindless zombie-like creatures that can explode. Unfortunately, things go kind of south, and Batman ends up in a sticky situation. And there's a crazy cliffhanger ending. The story is really, really good here. I've been enjoying this quite a bit. I think Joshua Williams' best work is in here, in this series. Unfortunately, I'm not a huge fan of the art. It is very nice, clean, simplistic style, but I don't like how everybody looks really elongated at times. Sometimes Superman's head looks really stretched out, other times it looks normal. But it is a nice, clean style. I just don't like the proportions. I think that needs to be worked on. He draws Batman really well, most of the time. And the Ultrahumanite looked pretty cool, but there's a lot of times that Superman has that giant forehead, or his head looks long or weird or something. But he does fine with people in costume most of the time. I'm not sure what that's all about. But it does kind of work. It's not terrible art. It's just not a style I prefer. The story, however, does save it for me, and I have been enjoying the series overall. So I will absolutely recommend this book. I thought it was fun. It's definitely approachable. You could jump in on this issue and not feel too left out. They do a good job bringing you up to speed through the dialogue and what's going on in the book. So if you miss the first part, it's not a massive deal. You will miss the unfortunate happenings to Atomic Skull, who I think was a very underutilized character and had a lot of potential as a hero, especially with his redemption story. So I kind of feel a little cheated that they killed him, because cool character. But this is turning out to be a good story, and I am enjoying it. So I'm looking forward to reading issue 11, where this does continue. Until then, I'm going to recommend this and say it's worth checking out. Thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you'd like to help the channel in other ways, links are in the description. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.